As we have studied in fluid mechanics that a fluid always contains a viscosity where it is flowing from one part to another part. And we also know that a solid and a liquid have a force between them. That force is called as an adhesive force. So we have to combine these two concepts, that is viscosity of the fluid as well as the adhesive force, in learning what is boundary layer theory. Concept of boundary layer theory. Or concept of boundary layer. Now, let us study what is boundary layer. So now, for a boundary layer, we have to combine two concepts. That is, first, that is concept of adhesive force, and second, concept of viscosity of a fluid flow. So now, let us understand these two concepts. Now first, we know that what is adhesive force? Adhesive force is a force between two different molecules. Here, we'll consider the adhesive force between a solid and a viscous liquid or a viscous fluid. Now, over here, we have to consider a solid surface. So let us consider a solid surface which is somewhat random in shape and a fluid which is flowing through this entire part. Let us consider the viscous fluid having a velocity u, and this entire solid surface as a stationary solid. That means it is at rest. Now what happens when this viscous fluid runs over this entire solid? Over here, near the vicinity of this entire surface, there will be a generation of boundary layer. Now what is exactly a boundary layer? A boundary layer is in close vicinity of a solid surface where the adhesive force between the boundary layer and the fluid is very large. So over here we can consider, supposingly this is the surface. So here the boundary layer will look something like this. And beyond the boundary layer, the velocity gradient almost becomes zero. So over here, du by dy is maximum. But beyond that, du by dy is almost zero. Now let us understand this. So now, first thing we need to understand is the adhesive force. So let us consider this as the free surface of the solid. And in the vicinity of the solid, we have this small amount of layer. Now, over here, there are two things which we have to take into consideration. That is, there is some force of adhesion between the fluid and the solid, as well as there is some velocity gradient because, of course, the velocity is moving. So, in the boundary layer, there will be some maximum velocity gradient, but beyond the boundary layer, the velocity gradient will be zero. So, over here, maximum velocity gradient will be near the surface. Now, we should understand always there is no slip condition. Now, what do you mean by no slip condition? Now, when this fluid is flowing at a very high velocity, there is a possibility that the fluid nearer to the surface of the solid might slip. So, here The first assumptions we consider in boundary layer theory is there is no slip condition. Now, no slip condition means there is no slipping of the fluid on the solid surface, as well as the relative velocity between the solid as well as the boundary is zero. So we have considered this concept. Now, boundary layer can be interpreted into two parts. First part, we can write over here. Let us write down part one, how to interpret a boundary layer. In a first part, the solid is stationary and the fluid is moving. So a small solid is over here and the fluid is moving at a very high velocity. The boundary layer will be formed at the surface or in near the vicinity of the entire solid body. Part 2 will be when the fluid will be at rest and the solid is moving. So over here, the fluid is at rest. If we draw a solid over here, so these are certain layers of the fluid. They are at rest. The solid is moving with some velocity u. The best example of these kind of scenarios are, this is moving of any automobile or airplane or any car, bike. Here the adjacent layers of the fluid are at rest, but the solid surface is moving. On the other hand, when the solid is stationary and the fluid is moving, this we can consider a building or any structure which is stationary, as well as the air is moving towards the structure. So what happens is, at the very vicinity or near the solid surface, there will be a creation of boundary layer where there will be maximum amount of shear stress, or rather velocity gradient, and there will be a minimum amount of velocity gradient after the formation of boundary layer. Here we should note that the boundary layer is always formed in the normal to the direction of the and is always formed in the normal to the direction of the flow, and it is perpendicular to the solid. So it is normal to the solid and it is perpendicular to the flow, and this range of the boundary layer is very small. So we have seen two things over here, that is the boundary layer formation when the velocity of the fluid which is moving, and the part where the solid is moving with some velocity. In both conditions, there will be formation of boundary layer. So I hope you have understood what is boundary layer theory and what are the considerations which we are going to take in studying boundary layer, that is no slip condition. Thank you.